ஹலோ கைஸ், இன்னைக்கு நாம இப்ப பார்க்க போறது பாருங்க மேக்னிட்டோ எஃபெக்ட். இப்ப காயின் எப்படி பறக்க போகுது? Welcome to my channel. This is Arun SV. Today I will show you how to make
coin levitation effect, that is coin floating in air, like one we saw in X-Men movie, like Magneto effect. Then this is the output in Adobe After Effects. I use CC 2014. Just watch it. In this effect, I use a Element 3D plugin and Money Casino pack from videocopilot.net. Kindly, I open new project, file, new project. This is the Adobe After Effects window. Now, open the folder, then import the required clip, then drag it to new comp like this. This is a 1080p HD footage. Then move the slider and select the starting point of the clip we required. In my clip, this is the starting point. Then press B on the keyboard to get the beginning point like that. Then move to the end of the clip where we want. Then press N on the keyboard to get the end point. Then trim comp to work area. Now go to composition settings and select the preset 720p HD, that is HD TV 720p, 25 frames. I choose 25 frames, I leave it. You make it 24 or 23.976, anything. Now right click and select it to comp size, because I have a low config PC, so I choose 720p HD composition. If you want 1080p composition, choose it. Now create a new solid, black solid, then name it as E3D coin, that is Element 3D coin. Then go to effect and move on to video copilot and choose the element plugin. Then click the setup. Now go to Casino Money Casino pack. This is from videocopilot.net. Then this is the coin I chosen. Then okay. Now move on to group 1, then create a null object. In this element plugin, the null object controls the movement of the coin, that is a group 1 object. Coin belongs to group 1. So scale down to match the real footage coin. Now we going to animate the coin, that is animate the null object, also animate the coin. So turn all the switches on, stopwatch on, so that it records all the animation of the null object connected to the coin. At the certain time, the coin go to its position, so move all the keyframes. Then at the starting of the clip, the coin lie down on the table. So at move the slider to starting point, then move the position of the coin at the table, then slightly rotate the X rotation to change the orientation of the coin lying on the table itself. Now when we play the clip, press 0 to 0 on the keyboard to play the clip like that. We get a nice animation, but the coin appears very smooth. To get a vibrating coin, alt click on the stopwatch, then type wiggle, wiggle, open bracket, 2,20, like that. It gives some nice reflection on the orientation. Now the coin slightly vibrates in random motion in the orientation. Then we want some animation with the rotation keyframes, X rotation, Y and Z rotation from starting point to end point. It is a random motion, so I choose some X rotation, Y rotation. You choose whatever you want respect to your video itself. This is the animation without using strings. It is CG animation. If you choose 1 or 0, it means you choose 1, it denotes 1 complete rotation, that is 0 to 360 is the 1 complete rotation. Then animate it with the time. Like that. Now when we run the clip, we get the output like this. I already make a video on the coin, like Shivaji the Boss coin animation. I use this same technique in that video. One of the subscriber asked me how to rotate the coin in that clip, so I make this tutorial for everyone. Never forget to turn on the motion blur switch on all the layers. It gives some reality to the animation. Then now select the E3D layer, then choose the anchor point tool. Then move the anchor point just below the coin. It acts as a mirror point for the E3D coin and the shadow layer on the table. So duplicate the layer for shadows. So rename it reflection shadows or shadow reflection like that. Now drag the position like that. It is like we can make it with scale Y or manually just drag from this. Now choose blur to Gaussian blur for the shadows, then increase little bit. Because the table doesn't reflection clearly. Now when we play the animation, we get the shadow on the table. One thing I forgot in this tutorial, that is reflection map. It gives some reality to that video. So select the element 3D, then in the element plugin go to render settings, then enable AO, that is ambient occlusion, that gives some shadow. So turn it to 5, then go to the scene setup. Okay, one thing, select the material, then turn down the reflection to 60, that is already 90. Turn down the intensity to 60, then give OK. Now go to custom layers, go to custom layers, then custom texture, select the video layer, then go again to setup, then go to reflection texture, click, then choose to custom layer 1, that is the video layer, then turn the UV repeat to nearly 2 or 3 in X and Y, 2, 3, so that it reflects in a perfect way, then give OK. We can't see reflection because it is only 60 reflection intensity. Now we press 0 on the keyboard to run the preview. I think it is nice. I am satisfied with these settings. Then select all the layers, then pre-compose it. Pre-compose. Okay. Now select the layer, then press S on the keyboard for scale, then click the stopwatch on, then zoom it a little bit, increase the scale with the time like that. at the starting point 100 and the end point 110. Now make a new black solid that is named box. It is for aspect ratio, letterbox settings like cinematic views. Take the pen tool or rectangular tool and draw the box. Now add to subtract, then remove the title save frame. Move the rest to quarter so that it renders fast. Now we get a better cinematic look like letterbox frame. Then go to create a adjustment layer, then type levels. No, auto level doesn't work for the settings, so bring the levels and give some black to the video. Adjust the settings little bit to make your desired views. Now when we render it, the final output will be like this. This is the final output. That's it. Thank you for watching.
Any trouble on this tutorial, please comment below. Then never forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. This is Arun SV. Stay tuned. Stay connected with me in Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We will meet you next time. Bye.